Hello, everyone. I'm Erica.
And I'm Akilah.
Welcome to Hearts Chat.
Hello, everyone. Welcome to another episode of Hearts Chat. Today, we'll be sharing tips on how to cope with quarantine and social distancing. Let's start with our check-in.
So, Erica, what have you been up to?
I have been using my Nike Running Club app. So this is an app that I've had for years. Okay, I've had it for years. I use it, but I never really added my friends on there or like kind of tried to, hey, you guys want to join the Nike Running Club app so we can track each other? So I have a group of ladies that are on there with me and we've been doing running challenges. It really helps to keep me motivated. And what I love about it is, you know, I've had it, but I didn't always use it as much as I use it now. And I love that when you go on there, you can, you know, set a challenge for yourself to meet for a certain period. Or if you just want to go for a run, you can press it and then you can save your runs, post them, and then you can track your progress. So you can see that this time I went longer distance and I was faster than last week. So it's really, really motivating. And I think with everything going on, not being able to connect with people like that, like, oh, let's all get together and go. You know, we really can't do that. It's another way to kind of keep us together and connected, and it's healthy. So yeah, that's my thing that I've been really into. One of my things. There's always all these things I'm doing.
But it's always good suggestions because you're always giving me suggestions like, didn't think about that.
Definitely check it out if you want to get it. I'm surprised I didn't tell you about it. But if you get it, I'll find you on there so I can add you to my circle and then you can join the challenges.
You probably didn't because I don't run. So,
but you know what? My mom has it and she walks and she'll be like, okay, I did my 5 mile walk today. And that's how.
Oh, awesome.
My aunt too, she'll do like a couple miles, she'll walk. So whatever level you're on, you know, it just kind of.
Interesting.
I don't know, just something to do.
Something to do.
What about you?
Actually, along that line, you know, I said I don't run, but I am doing some other exercising that I just started. Our topic today is about the quarantine. But since that, I've been doing yoga. So I'm doing like a 30-day challenge of yoga with Adrienne. I don't know if you guys have heard of her, probably, because she's like big in the kind of yoga community on YouTube.
Yeah.
So I'm on day 19. I haven't done it yet because I moved my schedule to doing my yoga after work. It really kind of helps me breathe and transition from working from home to having fun at home.
Right.
It relaxes my mind. I got really excited because I'm getting the poses. I've done this challenge like when it first came out. I think this came out like 2009 maybe. I think that's how long. It's been a while. When it first came out, Erica, like I was telling you, like the way I'm doing it now, I'm really like into it. So now I can finally plant my heels when I'm doing like down dog and, and like do all of these balancing poses that I think are super cool. And I'm like, yes, I did it. And I feel really good about it. At least one accomplishment a day.
Yeah, it's so nice. I love that. I really do. All right. So going on with our topic, we're going to go through just a few tips to help you cope with being quarantined and social distancing. So the first tip I think is really important is to stay positive. What I mean by that is to remain solution focused. Let's plan for better days. So an example of that might mean you could make a checklist of things that you want to get done that will benefit you when this is over. So that's what it means to kind of plan for better days, try to be positive and be solution focused. Something else you could do is maybe it's going through your closet and getting rid of old clothes, or maybe it's organizing that space in your home that you always say you're going to do, but you never do. So those are some examples. Or try to think of a productive thing that you can do at home that you otherwise wouldn't really have the time for. So those are some things you can do. And then another thing to stay positive is to write in your gratitude journal. And that's something we've been talking about for a long time. We've been
getting
that tip out for a while. Yeah, and even like with my sisters, any of us, if someone's having a hard time, that's something I always remind them of. Like, don't forget about your gratitude journal, because it's helpful to not only write in it when you need to, but also look back at what you wrote in it before to kind of remind yourself. Those are just a couple things you can do to try to remain positive.
Absolutely. And kind of going off of that, Erica, kind of what you're saying is, I definitely agree. We need to kind of try to stay positive and make the best of what we can and can't do kind of situation. I think on the other side of this too, is that also to stay positive, not to put pressure on yourself to be this wild, productive person because we all are allowed to feel kind of that sadness, that all of these feelings during this time, because this is a huge global change. It is okay to allow yourself that time to say, I'm not doing anything today, and that's okay. I think it's really important to kind of check in with yourself and say, okay, today, you know, I might do this. Today, I might do that. Along with Erica's suggestion of staying positive, it is also positive to do nothing as well.
Exactly. And I do that a lot.
So
you need that. And it's funny because I've been talking to some of my coworkers. We all are working from home now. And so it's like, how do you say, I'm not coming in today? You know, I need a day. But it's like, when we transition, I'm so thankful to have the opportunity to work from home and that I can, you know, continue to work.
Absolutely but grateful.
You have that transition where, okay, all this is going on. You still at work, you're anxious, you're nervous. Okay, well, now we're home. Like, oh, sigh of relief. I'm home. I feel safer. But when is it okay to be like, you know, I need a day. I need a break. Because how are you going to say, oh, I'm sick today, I can't show up? And, you know, some people, of course, you can't. Your head hurts, you need to rest, you need to relax. But that's hard. Like, oh, I need a vacation. Oh, you're at home. But you do. You do.
You do. You're right, Erica. And, you know, because at the same time, we're still working. Like, it's not like we're all just sitting home doing nothing. For the people who do have the privilege of working from home, you are still working. So just like anything else, you need a break. And it's okay to have a break. You know, I feel like sometimes it's us feeling guilty for just needing that break, or our bosses being like giving us a side eye, like, you're home, like, why do you need a break? Like, no, just because I'm home doesn't mean I'm actually not actively working.
Exactly. I love that you brought that point up. Another tip is to make a daily things to do list. That's something else you can do. So that can look like, today I'm going to meal prep. It doesn't have to be a long list either, or it could be today I'm going to read 4 chapters of my book. I'm going to take an Epsom salt bath. That's one thing you can add on your list.
Or, I should do that.
Yes. I love bubble baths, so I'm doing it. Epsom salt bath, bubble bath, soak, all of it. That's my thing. Another thing could be, I'm booking a 4 p.m. at home nail salon appointment. Something else I've done. You could try to make it, like, I guess, as normal, quote unquote, as you can. Something like that, you know, set a time that you want to do that. Honestly, trust me, I can book your entire day with beauty treatments.
Yes, yes, Erica. You want?
I can fill your whole day with anything. So even if you want me to plan your whole day, because you can clean your car. That's something else you can do. I just think it's important just to take advantage of some of this time that you have, whether it's a productive thing or a self-care thing that you want to do.
Yes, absolutely, absolutely. Erica, that tip is definitely perfect. The exact thing I was thinking, like, it doesn't have to be this long, massive list. It just, at least so you feel like you have some, like Erica said, some sense of normalcy in your day. I keep lists all the time. I probably keep too many lists, but it helps me stay organized. And the other thing about lists, we feel sometimes on the list, we have to get everything done that we have on that list. There are plenty of days where I look at my list and I'm like, I'm not getting that done today. Cross off, put it on tomorrow. There are so many things that I've moved to the next day because I don't feel like doing them. But they will eventually get done, no matter kind of whether it's productive or self-care, which self-care can be productive, but we'll make that distinction for you guys. You know, whether it's self-care or productive, it's just important to know kind of yourself and how you're feeling that day. But lists are absolutely amazing.
Something else you can do is set goals. So you can start your fitness goals, go for a walk, start yoga like you did, Akila, meditation. A lot of gyms are offering free workouts online right now. That's something else you can do. And then a friend of mine's actually working on a cooking website because she loves to cook. So you can also start a passion project.
Oh, that's a really good idea. Right now, we have some of us have a lot of time to kind of figure out and start some of the things, you know, that we may not have had time prior to, because when you really take driving out of the equation, it's a completely different life for some of us. There's a lot of people out there who still have to drive and are essential workers, like going out into the field. But for the other of us who aren't really driving right now, like, I feel like that zaps so much energy.
I know. Especially if you're in Jersey.
Oh my gosh. Yes, especially in Jersey. But it's like we have that time to kind of do some of these things. which is a good idea. Just set some goals that you want to get done.
You know, I don't know what I'm talking about because I live in D.C. So
exactly. That's what I was going to say. I was like, wait a minute.
Yeah, it saves up a lot of time and energy. Then our final tip is to be social. What I mean by that one is you can get on video chat, you can get on Google Hangout, you can go on Zoom, FaceTime, whatever. You know, you can set dates with your family and friends. My friend, she wants to do a virtual happy hour.
Yes, I did that with some friends.
Yeah. You got to get creative.
Yes. If you could do like any type of virtual hangout with friends, family, it really is fun. And, you know, especially as people you haven't seen in a long time too, and you're catching up. Virtual happy hours are absolutely amazing. I love them.
Yeah. Make phone calls and spend time talking to people. Same as you, Akila. I talked to one of my old girlfriends. I haven't talked to her in years. I was just thinking about her. And so I reached out and she was like, oh my gosh, I was thinking about you too. We were just like chopping up on the phone. You know?
That's awesome.
It was so nice. And you kind of just can reconnect with people that otherwise, you know, it's one thing when I guess in our profession, when somebody comes in and says, oh, I can't do this, this, that, part of our job is to, I don't know, kind of help them figure out and try to navigate that. So I feel like I'm always looking for opportunity to be like, oh, you could do it at this time, or you could do it at that time, or this could work, or that could work. But when you have, I guess, when it's right in your face, like, oh, you have all this time, I think that makes it a little bit easier. And you think, like, okay, I have all this time to do it. Versus before, you know, like how I mentioned before about me and Nicole setting up our conversations like once a month. Before, it's like, okay, how do I fit this in my schedule? I can give it once a month.
Yes.
It's different now. Absolutely. Another thing with being social is you can also start telehealth therapy sessions. Even if that's just to talk about your worries or just feeling alone, because some of us live alone.
Absolutely. That's what I'm doing right now is actually giving telehealth, and something that's, I don't know, a lot of people, I guess this is, can go on the other topic as well that we'll have, but a lot of people might not know right now, if you have insurance, they're waiving your copays for you to do it. So it's essentially like free right now for a lot of people. Definitely, definitely reach out. It's different by every state. I can only discuss about Jersey, but I know in Jersey, they're right now kind of trying to gather up volunteers to give out free telehealth therapy to like the essential workers. I know New York has already had that. Erica, you're absolutely right. Telehealth therapy is a very good thing to use during this time.
Okay, Liz, you have any other tips?
The only thing I think I will say is that the other day I saw this post on Facebook from a fellow therapist that someone, I can't remember her name. Where is it? You know, I had her name, but she's a therapist and she's actually a psychologist in New York State. And she kind of created us tips for quarantine, which is really, really cool. And maybe that's something we can kind of post up. Mm-hmm. And it kind of reiterates some of the stuff that we were saying for, you know, how to cope with the quarantine and social distancing. So that's something that would be cool to check out as well.
Very cool. Well, of course, there's so much more you can do to cope with.
Absolutely.
Yeah, there's a whole lot of things you can do, but we hope these tips inspire you to try them, or maybe it helps you think of some other ideas that you might want to try during this time.
Absolutely.
All right. Well, we'll catch you next time.
Bye.
Bye.
Thank you so much for listening to Harsh Chat today, where we speak from the heart. We hope that you enjoyed our show. Catch us weekly on our YouTube channel and our website, which is harshchat.org. Be sure to follow us on our social media pages at Harsh Chat.
We'd love to hear from you. If you have any questions or topics that you would like for us to talk about, email us at contact@harshchat.org. And for all of your personal relationship questions, visit our website, harshchat.org. Click the From Erica's Heart tab to ask your question anonymously, and we will respond within 24 hours.